45 minutes. So before taking much time, let me go to give my presentation. So the agenda of today's presentation will be like we will talk about the visitor management system and it's important for business. Then how COVID-19 and business is changing the, of course, the behavior of the people, the behavior of the organization, how the organizations are more concerned about visitor as compared to the time when there was nothing called COVID. Then we will have some narratives with the perspective of COVID-19. Then we will talk a little about the EVMS that Micro Center has evolved with that can address these kind of challenges and narratives. And finally, we will have a closing note. So when we talk about visitor management system, it is nothing but it is a manual that is managing the arrival, presence, and departure of the visitors from the workplace. So basically, it is the science of who, where, when, and how long. So in your workplace, there are number of visitors, including you can have the contractors, delivery personnel, workers, client, job candidates, or other staff. To manage them, there is a need of a digital management system. So visitor management system may include a variety of features, such as screening systems, then touchless sign-in, contract tracking, scheduling, and many more. That is what is the need of the hour at this moment, that you need to look at your visitor very carefully, and sometime, you know, that you need to track back to find out exactly when they came, to whom they met, and who were the first contact in the way if they are getting infected with COVID. So if you will see, this is a simple workflow system of visitor management system. If there is a new visitor, you can have either these kind of devices here that will be used at the reception. So collect visitors, details, capture photographs, visiting card for ID, and you know, most of the system are equipped with ID card readers or passport scanner and other kind of input devices. From there, you can manage the visitor pass, and then visitor meets the host at the office or plant. And then after the meeting, host sign on the visitor pass, and then visitor proceed for the exit pass. This is the process. But in the case of the existing registered visitor, you can simply search and select visitor record and you can print out and so on. But now, like even people do not want to, you know, touch the CPR card or the, you know, normal visiting card of any visitor. So in this case, what is happening that you are using a QR card management system or a simple touchless system or face recognition or any kind of system that will help you to go touchless as far as the login and logout of users are concerned from your organization. So now if you will see, mostly you will have these kind of people who are visiting, and there you need some kind of pre-registration when they are checking into the facility. It is not like that somebody is coming there and after that the security personnel is getting this wonder that whom to allow, whom not to allow. So it's better to have a mechanism where you can request people that whenever you are looking forward to come to our organization, you kindly come here and look into and give and furnish this kind of information from all these stakeholders. Now, when we will talk about some of the functional areas of the EVMS, if you will see here, some of the areas are there. So any smart visitor management system that present a modern and professional look for your business, you can notify your staff. See, you see here, the visual identification, you will have the visual identification here. You can have the visitor management data, you can log into this data and you can find out, you can have the ID verification, you will create the watch list, I will talk about this in the coming slides. You will have the approval workflows, sign-in management, then pre-registration if something is there, then finally alert and notification. So I was saying that when somebody is coming to your organization, you can notify your staff quickly via email or SMS text messages. When a visitor is arriving, For them, it is, you know, very, very important to manage the health and safety procedure for both the visitor as well as for the staff. Like, for example, ensure all data remains private and enjoy customization settings to showcase your branding event right from the first encounter when the guests are coming and welcomed at the reception. So this is something that is very important. At the same time, you will have the efficiency of managing the visitor. You will have the showcase of your professionalism, that how you are handling your visitors in a fantastic way, and ultimately you will be able to comply with the regulation of the government when it comes to health and safety. Now, what are some of the few key benefits of a visitor management system? So you will see there is something that is proactive security. That is, of course, the number one criteria. Then you will have the increased efficiency, and then streamlined compliance, auditable visitor data, centralized location management. I will talk about that also in detail. Then brand impact of an organized and efficient visit. So these are some of the major benefits when we talk about a very good, a smart visitor management system. Now, when we talk about optimized visitor efficiency, what does it mean? The way security and facility professionals are leveraging visitor management technology is become increasingly sophisticated in these days. How? The companies are realizing that checking in guest is just part of the visitor journey. It's not like, you know, a receptionist is there, somebody is coming, you know, and they are managing them accordingly. No, it should be taken care of with respect, with dignity, and with efficiency, so that they will feel, the customer or visitor will feel the part of the organization, and they will feel always pride in moving into. So the visitor cycle starts before the visitor even steps foot on site on your company. So inviting guests and providing them visitor logistics, such as, like, for example, if you will see here, the directions, the parking designation, and collecting necessary documentation, booking meeting rooms and meeting host allows for seamless communication before, during, and after the visit. So the optimization of the overall process of the visitors, when the visitors is trying to get an appointment, reaching to the organization, then having meeting with the concern and coming out from there, this is something that we are looking at. And this is the outcome of some research that they have found that less than 30 seconds is required when you are trying to check in your guest if you have an efficient visitor management system. So, like the increased visibility and branding, I have taken here the example of this bank, Bahrain and Kuwait. This is actually one of our, you know, customer. They are using this smart visitor management system. And of course, we have this testimonial also that came from their, you know, I mean, management. So as I was saying, the visitor experience is important, and we have to try hard to make the first impression to client, as I was speaking in the last slide. So the clients, there might be some potential customers, there might be some potential employee, there might be some visitors who will, of course, talk positive word of mouth about the processes, about the way that you are handling your visitor. So your reception area is the first part of entry. So every organization need to make it warm and welcoming a space to, you know, welcome your guest. So digital sign-in can help with this. You can also show your visitor that you truly care about their safety and security using a data privacy compliant system, and leave your guest feeling impressed right from the beginning as the journey into your world, your company, your business. So then another very, very important point is about the workplace security. So companies place a high security emphasis on safeguarding their people, facilities, their IP, financials, and the data. And this can be challenging, especially when managing multiple locations with a high number of visitors. But our visitor management system are viewed as a crucial part of an organization security strategy. And, you know, as I was mentioning about the research, the outcome is that over 92% of the organization said that VMS create a safer environment. That is an increase from, of course, you know, 2017 and 18. And in addition, when it came to ranking the reason for purchasing a VMS, respondents cited security as a primary reason next to compliance. So these metrics represent the dependency the companies have on visitor management system to screen visitors, maintain visitor record for each location, and with the ability to conduct background check, place visitors on watch list, verify IDs, sign documents electronically, and create custom badges, organizations are gaining a stronger understanding of who is visiting their site, why they are visiting, and when they are visiting, how much time they are spending in your organization. Having visibility and control over the visitors' process is adding a new layer to the overall security of your workplace. And according to the Occupational Safety and Health Administration data, in the year 2019, 5,147 fatal workplace injuries have been occurred. This is the data that is from United States, and they have found that out of this, 458 were cases of intentional injury by another person in the workplace. So the lobby or reception of any organization is always serving as the first line of defense for security. So the feature of a visitor management system can help to identify when undesirable situation might occur, including instant notification, the ability to monitor multiple entry and exit points, digital agreement compliance, evacuation management, and of course the ID badge, so that you can track exactly that at a, you know, circumstances that is unavoidable and that is not pleasing, that at what location, how many people are there. So a visitor management system will help you comply with all the data and privacy law which are coming from the government time and again. So, yeah. Now, once we are talking about the compliance issues, when we are talking about the regulations, then of course, there is increase in complexity as well, because now we are talking about, let's say, this multiple locations are there. So a visitor management focus shifted from, you know, security to, you can say, more about compliance in this day. And of course, it increased the complexity and the scope of the project as well. So for organizations, the requirement fall along two vectors in these days. And of course, that is the scale and customization. So when a visitor management solution is rolled out across different sites within the facility portfolio, the needs of each location have to be accounted for, because the requirement at one location cannot be the same at another location. For example, it is not only about the companies, it is not only about the commercial setup, it is also about the high security research facilities, manufacturing sites, executive briefing centers, campus locations, and all of these have different safety regulations. Their access protocols are different, and of course, the visitor logistics are also different. So the solution that address the challenges for one site may not necessarily support the needs of numerous different location. Maybe, you know, like unique geographical regulations as well, the sea area, maybe the sand area, the land area, and all that. So all these things has to be taken care of when you are moving ahead with multiple locations. And these kind of complexities are happening when you are talking about the visitor management system, which is going to help you out. Now, we will talk about that, how we are going to, you know, manage the security and how the narratives that will help the, of course, the security managers as well as the business leader at the moment. So if you will see, the first important one is the identity of your visitor, that understanding your guest, the evolution of the visitor identity. And you see the 98% of the people say that VMS is helpful in creating a safe environment, because it will help you to know exactly who is your visitor, why they are coming, when they are coming, how much time they are spending. So this visitor identity will of course help you to safeguard and make the workplace a safe environment. Then the risk mitigation. So 90% of 19% is the increase in the data risk in the recent years. So balancing data privacy with security demand is something that is very, very crucial for any organization. And last but not the least, the compliance requirement. The regulations of the government, like here in Ministry of Health, the regulations from NHRA, of course, the regulation from Ministry of Works, LMRA, and so on. All these compliance has to be adopted to the business in order to be, you know, as per the norms. So if you see this data, 22% increase in compliance prioritization also happened. So these are the three narratives. We will try to talk a little bit about all these, that how the visitor management system can help us. So the first one, if you see, the VMS implementation based on compliance, it's gone to 38% in 2019. As of 2018, that was 16% only. So there is 22% increase. And in 2020, of course, you know, due to COVID, the compliance is more and more robust, the compliance in more and more complex as well. So, of course, it is going up. So compliance has become a key driver for visitor management implementation, steadily growing in influence, as you see, over year by year. And one of the visitor key role is visitor management system key role is the compliance. And it is like something that will help to anticipate and adapt to changes in the regulatory environment, because the regulations are changing according to the situation. Like if you will see, the task force or COVIDs are meeting, I believe, every month, and they come out with different kind of regulation, and these regulations has to be adopted and implemented by each organization where customers, visitors, suppliers, contractors, and all those are coming. So in recent year, growing number of high profile security incidents, data breaches, privacy violation lead to regulation changing along these two dimensions. And of course, the dimensions are the physical security and the data privacy. So it has to be looked very seriously from this perspective. Now, if you see the VMS features that help address compliance regulation, if you talk specifically, then you see the 70% of the respondents say that it helps in better audit request. And see, these are the 90% of the listed companies, they are saying, sorry, compliance, that as a top reason to get a VMS, and 90% said that it helped them respond to an audit. 68% of the people say that it helps them to have the electronic documentation system. Of course, it may be some kind of signatures, or maybe the face recognition, the picture clicking, and so on. And 62% people said that it helps in create an internal as well as external watch list. So what is this watch list? This watch list is the characteristic of the visitor. It is having all the past record. It will have his visit records, that where he has visited, where he has worked, and what is the criteria from the third party actually. Something one that is internal one that you will made according to the data that you have from the authorities and so on. And the third party is also providing data for each visitor of that nature. Of course, this is not important for small businesses or business of different nature. But in the case when you talk about the organizations where security is very, very important and crucial, where it is important to have the third party external watch list as well. And the system will help you to have those kind of analysis as well. Now, when we talk about the expanded influence, like we continue to see the growth of the VMS evolving from a check-in point solution to a holistic platform that moves visitor through every point of interaction with the facility and within the facility. And of course, simultaneously, it is improving many different aspects of the organization. The scope of influence of a VMS continues expansion into different organizational divisions. So it's gone now from security to the IT, legal, HR, health and safety, operations, procurement, facilities, corporate events, and these are a few. There might be some other, you know, operational areas, there might be some other departments that needed to be expanded and brought into the preview of visitor management system. So there is, if you will see at all, a growing trend in high-performing organization to leverage compliance program as an opportunity to improve their process, protect their interest, and earn the trust of their partner and customer. Because as I mentioned earlier, the visitors may be your prospective customers, the visitors may be your prospective employer, and visitors are the people who are going to talk either the positive word of mouth or negative word of mouth about the process you are welcoming and you are handling visitors in your premises. Now, the second important point, that how we are going to mitigate the risk, how we are going to balance, make a balance between the data privacy and security demands. So it is not only about the people, it is not only about the physical security, it's also about the compliance that we talked in the previous slide. So whether it is your internet, that is IP, your financial statement or employee and visitor information, there is a growing need for customers to safeguard their data. This is something that is very important. People do not want to, you know, furnish their personal information because of some kind of doubt, or they do not have trust. They feel that their data may be misused, or their data may be, you know, sold out further and so on. So even with all the high profile data breaches dominating the news, cyber attacks are not the only situation where a company information is compromised. On top of that, there is additional damage done to public trust, credibility, and business, overall business as a result. So enterprises leverage visitor management system to mitigate the risk associated with the visitor present at their facilities. Not only the digital risk, but the physical risk. So what type of risk could potentially be introduced? So if you will see here, you can have visitors from countries that are prohibited from entering, highly regulated site, visitors overhearing a conversation or seeing talking photo or maybe taking photo of sensitive information during their visits. So you have to look at that. Visitors remaining on site and venturing around after the meeting is completed, that you need to look at. Disgruntled employees from a different office location entering the site. Visitor using a false identity to gain access to the company's executives. Unexpected media trying to engage and gather information from employees on site. So these are some of the factors. That theft of hardware that has customer or employee data stored in it, that may have your business secrets, trade secrets. So now, how the VMS is going to address this risk, how we are going to mitigate this? So we will go one by one. The first of all, obtaining visitor information ahead of time before the visit is confirmed. That means running visitor invitations through review and approval process, pre-registering guests, and running guests through the third party or internal watch list that I was referring in last slide before they set foot on site. This is the first point that you have to be taking care of. Then second, gathering more information about the visitors, merging contact data with third party data. What is this? That means requiring visitor to provide country of origin information in case of the, you know, the organization is like that, where people are coming from all around the world. Then if some contractors are there, then validate the contractor credentials. Automating health related questionnaire can be set up in visitor management system for different types of visitor. This is very important now, that if someone is traveling from one country to another country, at the time when people are requesting for a visit, you can put a form, web form, where people can give their health information, that whether they have been affected with COVID or they have been visited to some places in last 14 days where there is some kind of COVID breakdown and so on. So these kind of information that you can take in second step. And the third, that validating visitor ID and information provided, that means how accurate and valid is the data provided by the visitor is something that is very, very crucial. So this is not only enough to capture the data. You have to have the additional layer of security. And this is that visitor management system can scan visitor IT detail right into the system rather than permitting manual entries. So like in Bahrain, it is always, good to use the CPR card. Everybody has got that smart card. So there should not be any manual entries. Additionally, you can have the level of security can be increased to include a security guard checking the validity of the identification document with the airport grade scanner. That is something I'm emphasizing on this, that it airport grade scanners. These scanners are, you know, very high profile in nature, and it can come out with any kind of glitches when it comes to the standard of the international system, when it comes to immigration and passport. Now, connecting visitor management with access control technologies. This is something that is the trend. This is something that will help you in maintaining and managing your physical security. So enabling access within the facility, either with existing access control technology or with a consolidated single access signal, mobile or biometric, is one of the trend that will help us in this security space. And here also, like, once you can have the face recognition system, or you can have a chip kind of system. So once the employee is coming there, or any visitor is coming out there, then you can see whether exactly the access control will allow them to come inside or not. Now, the last one here, the requiring host confirm check-in and check-out on the guest. This is also very important feature that most of the visitor management system must have. That is check-in. While self-check-in process is there, of course, and this is in use as well in many organizations, but in highly regulated areas or most compliant organization, accompanying visitor, that means one of the employee or person, whoever is entering into your premises, there need to be one person who will be always accompany the visitor, and this is something that is a compliant requirement for most of the organization. And VMS here can enable that with a mobile application, the host can check in or check out the visitor with their ease of time. So these are some of the points that you need to maintain. These are some of the ways that you can help as far as the risk mitigation is concerned. Now, that I was saying that you need to understand your guests. So the visitor identity, identifying your guest. So it used to be earlier, you know, the government ID scanning, pre-scanning were reserved for government-grade security checkpoints like borders, airports. But now, as I was mentioning, the research and development facilities, manufacturing site, technological corporate offices, educational organizations are introducing proactive security measures. And in many areas, there are safety incidents that are the driving force for a visitor management system to be adopted. And it may be your disgruntled employees, the non-compliant contractor, the visitors with malintention and with criminal intention, and more enterprise companies are committing resources to minimizing risk level for negative incident and are proactively safeguarding their people, their IP, their financials, and overall data. So increased interest in check-in visitor against a variety of third-party and internal watch lists that we have discussed, this is something that is going to help you. Now, so physical identities are something where you need to merge with the digital identity. That means, you know, whatever information have been furnished before, that you have to see that whether this is something that is exactly in the form of the physical person or not. Because digital theft and digital problems and phishing is something the whole world is having trouble with. So a vendor, contractor, job applicant or customer should have their identity validated and visit purpose confirmed before they should enter. So see, the 74% of the organization feel that watch list to feel visitors present a threat to their data. So before they are allowing somebody to enter, they have prepared a particular watch list on the basis of the historical data, and they always want to make sure that they are carrying into that. And 92% of the people say that VMS create a safer environment because you can screen the people with malintention, you can screen the people with history that may be harmful for your organization, for your IT, for your data, and so on. Now, what about the coronavirus pandemic, COVID-19, and VMS? How this is going to help us? So we will start from this. It's a pretty, you know, long sentence, but this is very important. That's why I put it here. So contact tracing is the most important consideration in these days. How do you log the movement and workplace interaction of guests in a way that promotes transparency, build traceability into your visitor experience in a non-invasive way? So the goal of traceability is a clear picture of where and when guests interact with facilities and your employees. In the event of a positive case of COVID-19, whether from a visitor or an employee, facility managers can comb through the data to find possible exposure point. And this is must-have system for facilities opening their door to a revolving population of visitors who may or may not follow the same standard as employees. So question is, what we can do in this case, how we can go for the traceability, and how visitor management system can help us to combat this problem from the visitor and employees. So here are some of the employees. So first of all, assign visitor badges that create a roadmap of where they move within the facilities. Then timestamp guest access to different areas of the facilities to log employees overlap. So when you will run a report, in case if you found that a particular person, either a visitor or employer or contractor, you know, is positive, then you can see that he or she entered in the premises at this particular time, he was at reception, then he moved to lobby at this particular time. So it will help you to find out during that particular time who are the different people who met them. Then have digital check-in and check-out confirmation and itineraries for record keeping. This is something that is very important nowadays. Then set up a system to make guidelines clear and present for guests. For example, send an email confirmation after they book a visit that contains a quick synopsis of guidelines. This is very, very important. These rules need to cover all important aspects of what is expected of them, including mask and PPE uses and guidelines, like visitor must wear a mask, maybe a PPE in case if there is, you know, more inspections. Then social distancing rules and protocol that observe floor arrows or whatever in your organization. Then personal hygiene standard like hand washing, or you can have disinfectant. Then facility specific guidelines according to your organization that how to use your workspace. And this is something that is alarming. Then do not expect visitors to know the COVID-19 policy for your workplace. They know the national health plan, but they don't know that how you are implementing in your organization. Even it is rooted in General Ministry of Health or WHO guidelines, give your visitors clear expectation to follow, and they will feel more comfortable abiding by them instead of wondering that what is acceptable during their visit to your premises. And for that, something in these days, appointment management system, that is very important. So people cannot come as walk-in in these days, and you should not allow as well. You can have this process of appointment management system. So here you see the person is starting here, the appointment he's requesting. This is a step one. And you can use the mobiles as well. Most of the good applications are having mobile application as well. So he will start, and then if the appointment is approved, he will reach here. So there will be a check-in and temperature check process will be there. So your data is already there. So if you can have a face recognition system, or they can have some kind of a scanning mechanism or some kind of wireless mechanism that you can put, a lot of different techniques are available. So the check-in process will happen. First, we will confirm, okay, is the right person. Then the temperature check, fever is in the range. Then he will check in inside, and then he will go and meet the person. And before that, there is a notification of the host. So host will be ready. Okay, this particular person who came to see you, he's already inside, so please go and meet that particular person. Then meeting will happen, and ultimately he will check out from there and he will see that. Now, in some of the good visitor management system, there are reports that the security guard can see at a very moment that who are the people who are overstaying inside an organization, and then they can check with the host and they can take the necessary action. Now, the other way of appointment is when the organization is calling somebody from outside. This you have to adhere at the time of COVID, very, very important. So in the case if an invitation that is sent by the host, this will be accepted by the guest, then guest will visit the venue, and here guest is authenticating his identity and temperature check is happening. Then the guest is checking in, and of course, if there is a meeting, seminar, webinar, whatever, he'll send there, and after that, the checkout process will happen. Now, we will talk a little about the Micro Center visitor management system. That is something that that I want to emphasize, that how it is going to help as far as the COVID-19 is one of the major factor that is concerned, and then security and compliance requirement. So I will take only a few minutes to discuss about the measures. So first of all, permissions. This is something that is very, very important in any visitor management system. And why I'm saying that? Visitor need a strict yes or no. Access to different areas of facilities to keep them safe and to limit distraction to, you know, that the guy should not feel that he is in some kind of, you know, like a place that he doesn't know exactly that where he can go, where he should not. So the company, for example, company cafeteria, yes, he can go. But there is some kind of research and development laboratories, no, he cannot go. And access control or other kind of permission-based technologies are key in visitor management system or not. So when we talk about the permission, you need to make your visitor understand, to see, these are the places where you can visit. These are the places where you cannot. Now, second one is the accessibility. So the flip side of permission is accessibility. Visitor don't want to feel like they're in prison, as I was saying, like, you know. So make sure they know exactly what they have access to, as well as where to find these areas on a map. In an enterprise system, this need to extend from location to location too. As I was talking about the concept of multi-location, like I was, I will discuss in the prevailing slide also, that how you can have the GIS-based location management system, and you can have the 3D modeling to see exactly that how your visitors are there and how they are behaving at a given moment of time. The third one is traceability. That is something that is very, very important from, you know, COVID perspective. So especially now during COVID-19, traceability is a key part of visitor experience. If there is a viral outbreak at your organization, or your any other facility, it may be your you know, like logistics center, it may be your inventory store, so on, you need to understand how guests at that location are affected, or if they are responsible for bringing it into facilities. So you have to find out. So for traceability, you need a very good visitor management system. And then synergy. Make the visitor experience fluid from start to finish. If a smooth check-in process culminates in someone wandering facilities aimlessly, the visitor experience suffers. So at an enterprise level, this means more touch points between check-in and check-out, so guests can easily get their bearings, wayfindings, and digital resources wherever they want. So there should not be confusion between permission, accessibility, traceability, and synergy. So all these things should be synergized exactly. When you are saying, okay, this area is something where you can have access to, so maybe you can have the, you know, like floor map with, you know, green painting, or you can have red painting, or you can have some kind of, you know, like display, so that people should not have any problem. And then finally, the automation. So when we talk about automation, so visitor management system need automation to reduce the burden of oversight on facilities managers, especially when managing multiple locations through a single cloud-based or, you know, like server-based system. So automate wherever possible welcome and departure emails, guest badge permissions, wayfinding routes, and more are all meaningful automation that improve convenience and save time. Then finally, the convenience. This is something that is important both for the employer and both for the visitor. It should be convenient for the visitor to go for appointment management. It should be convenient for the employee to go and, you know, accept or reject an appointment. And it should be convenient for the security guard to check in quickly that whether this appointment was confirmed or not. So ultimately, the visitor experience needs to be a convenience one. So even for the biggest companies, guests should feel quickly welcome and at ease thanks to a visitor management system that's seamless. With so many resources governing it, an enterprise system should anticipate and meet visitor need proactively. So this is what we talk about our system, our, you know, AVMS, that these are the six pillars that we are focusing on. So the permission, accessibility, traceability, synergy, automation, and convenience. Like some of these are some of the versions available for visitor management system according to the scope and according to the size of the organization. Like you can have a simple desktop version. So this is a kind of a startup kit, single user software on one smart card reader you can have and you can use it. Then you can have the server basic version. Here you will have 20 server network user license. You can have administrative user. You can have more than one smart card user. Then server standard version, if you will see server software with Oracle license here, of course you will have. Here you will have 50 server network users, notification mechanism. But if you will go with the advanced version, this advanced version will give you the appointment management. It will give you the 100 server network users, Active Directory interface, and of course, on the demand of the customers, we can have the 3D modules, we can have the GIS modeling of the premises, or we can have also, like I was talking, that VMS is not only for the visitors at the reception, now it is going to other departments and operations. So you can include your, you know, HR, you can include your, you know, other department to gain benefits out from this VMS system. So these are some of the dashboards, and of course this is our system, so it can be customized further and you can have different kind of, you know, availability as and when required. So you can have Active Directory sign-on, you can have the single sign-on concept SSO that is also available here. So you can have the information about all the users, and then automatically they will be having this idea. The admin will have the idea exactly that who is using the system. Then integration with HR database, I said. So the unique feature of EVMS enables user to access external database like directorates, sections, employees, and floors without feeding data manually. And then EVMS equipped with powerful feature of auto connection and feeding of required data from external databases like MS Server, MySQL, and Oracle. And see, this is, I was talking about, you know, time and again, that is about, this is the 3D model actually. If you will see, like here, this the software will tell you that in a given premises, where are the people available, and the green sign shows that this guy is still having the validated appointment time. Well, this person is overstayed over there. Even you can see the gender of the people, that who are the people at what different location. So this three-dimensional EVMS is an automated application for converting visitors as well as, you know, visit record stored as a schemas, tables available in database format into 3D visualization in 3D building mode. So even if you will take, you can see, like if you will take your mouse to that particular visitor, you can see the information, like this is floor 2, room name, visitor ID, then what time they entered, what is the total status, and all this information you can see. And it will give you an enterprise-wide idea about your customer. So thank you very much for your time and attention. This is something from my side. Now I will go for some question and answer if you have. Thank you. Now the floor is open for the question. Yeah, if you have question, maybe you can, you know, send us email, you can type in chat box so that we can answer you, we can reach you back. So I believe that it was, you know, pretty clear, and there is no questions, but we would love to listen from your side. If you have any kind of concern, if you want to know more, if you want to see the system in detail and have a system walkthrough session or demonstration, we will be happy to do that. So thank you very much for your time, concentration, and interest in us. Thank you. Have a great day, and blessed Ramadan to all of you.